Yeah.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
What? What?
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Dre, you ready?
Boom, 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 boom.
Come on.
Yo, we gotta
all right.
Check, 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 check. Cut him undercover. Timeless. Ready for him. Progress. Feeling like I'm just getting.
What's going on, YouTube, social media world? It's your boy Anonymous, based in on biggity biggity back, biggity biggity back, biggity 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 back with a new reaction video. This time we are getting into a brand new Dr. Dre track that just dropped, man. But before we get into it, go ahead and get this video a like, share with a couple of your friends. Make sure you follow me on all my social media sites. And if you got something specific, go ahead and drop it in that comment section. So we're gonna go ahead and get into a brand new Dr. Dre track, man. And this one is called Gospel, featuring Eminem and the D.O.C. people. All right, man. Let's go ahead and get into this.
Yeah.
Huh.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
What? What?
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Dre, you ready?
Boom, 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 boom.
Come on.
Yo, we gotta
all right. Go.
Check, 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 check. Cut him undercover. Timeless. Ready for him. Progress. Feeling like I'm just getting started. Two shots back for my dearly departed. You are now dealing with a monster. Oh shit. Profits. Dr. Dre, bitch, I'm a prophet. Like Wall Street, niggas know where the stock is. Try me. Niggas never see me, but it ain't hard to find me. Unwinding. Shit's blinding. Still grinding. I'm rising. Stop talking about the past, I'm the future, nigga. Nigga like me, still here, motherfucker, go figure. Looking for my next gold digger. This summer here gonna be colder than winter. Already told you, I fold you like hundreds of billions, and you can go missing, put that on my children. Bet that, nigga, what? Regret that, run it up. And I'm about to sum it up. This shit here, that problem. Living at the bottom of a bottle. Full throttle, my motto. Fucking with me like fucking with the lotto. That awful in your nostril, in a brothel. This is gospel, yeah. I'ma need all that pronto.
Yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir. I'm riding like that. Give a fuck if you bitches die. Put a motherfucking hole in your face. Back up, bitch, don't even try.
I am that motherfucker, been the coldest. Why you on that? No one know us. Overdosed on what dope is.
Yeah.
Hip hop shit sell better than the coke did.
Like a satanic cult, it's an old ritual slaughtering goats, bitch. You fucking with the original flow, sick, and anybody can get it. COVID. Fun with that, I don't roll shit that was so sharp, I could slip my own fucking throat with it. So rich, I got more chips than my shoulders, and I'm about as approachable as a roach's. Just so better steer clear from it. Here comes a nuclear bomb for your eardrums. Lyricism at its most fearsome and fierce. We're on another tier, like your tear ducts, upper echelon. Your career sucked, it was sheer luck. Like a fucking leprechaun with his beard cut. For the Punisher, weapon drawn with a beer gun.
Oh, hold on. Eminem said sheer luck like a leprechaun with his beard cut. So that means the leprechaun ain't lucky anymore, but at the same time it's sheer luck, because when you cut your hair, is technically you're shearing it off. So it's like you're cutting the luck by shaving the leprechaun. But at the same time, it's like, it's sheer luck because you're in contact with a leprechaun. That's crazy. That's kind of messing my head up.
Most fearsome and fierce, we're on another tier, like a tear duct's upper echelon. Your career subbing, it was sheer luck, like a fucking leprechaun with his beard cut. For the Punisher, weapon drawn with a beer gut. You're slower than a Decepticon with his gear stuck. And I what? I serial kill in your Kellogg's. I love checks and I hate tricks. And you're a fake bitch. I can spot you like you about to weightlift. Bitch, I'm better than cake mix.
I can spot you about to weightlift. For all my lifters out there, y'all get that reference, man. Let's get it back into it.
Can't be whipped with egg beaters. You cunts must be out of your labias. And God's my alias. So if I don't have faith in me, then it basically makes me an atheist. Nick Diaz got the world by the tracheas and the chokehold and a sleeper. Yeah, and me and Dre are like dog hair. We're both in our lab coats like retrievers. But like a Doberman, I'm a whole different breeder. Animal mutt mixed with an overachiever. Oh, you're the king of rap. You're about to be overthrown like a pass over the head of an open receiver. This shit could end up coming to blows like a wiener. But I ain't finished putting these hoes through the ringer. Like clothes in between the two rollers await. No flow. What I mean is flows interwoven. I treat them like thread. That's how I wind up sewing machine up. So fucks if you don't give them either time to ride or die. Cause you're either both or you need to throw them. Middle finger up if you're rolling. But me, I'm gonna
ride till I die. Give a fuck if you bitches die. Put a motherfucking hole in your face. Back up, bitch, don't even try. I am that motherfucker, been the coldest. Why you on that? No one know us. Overdose the one dope is. Hip hop shit sell better than the coke did.
Man, man, man. Shout out to Dr. Dre and Eminem and the DOC for coming through with the fire track called Gospel, man. Yo, I really don't even know where to start with this because it's like, it was kind of an overload, like a sensory overload, man, because it's like, it was too much fire in under 3.5 minutes. But let's go ahead and get into it. So, first impressions of me hearing this for the first time, man. Yo, Dr. Dre still got it. I'm not saying that he lost it, but him coming back after all this time and just dropping some heat out of nowhere, like he's aged very, very well. He's aged very, very gracefully. Like, you can hear the longevity and the maturity in him musically and everything else all around. Now, I definitely wasn't expecting this to just pop up out of nowhere. However, this was a very, very, very pleasant surprise, man. Dr. Dre came in and he treated it. He almost treated this like how he went hard on Chronic 2001. It still has that same type of that timeless energy to it, to where he can disappear for so much time and then come back and it's like he hasn't left. And that's how deeply ingrained the level of respect for this man is to the culture, to hip hop, and to music overall, man. And I gotta say, he came in spitting some bars, bro. Now, I wanna say that DOC was the one that was on the hook because, you know, for the hip hop fans that know, DOC got involved in an accident and he actually got one of his vocal cords damaged to where his career was pretty much over. So I'm going to go out on a limb. I didn't look up the lyrics or anything, but I'm going to go out on a limb and say that that was DOC on the hook because I hadn't heard any of his music after the music that he was putting out in the early 90s when he was actually up there, when he was out. And so it's kind of I wasn't really sure what to expect. Hearing his voice and like whether he was going to drop a verse or what, I didn't know what to expect of how he was going to come at the track or where he was going to be placed. So for him again, I'm assuming that's him on the hook. So for him to be on the hook, that was actually good because I guess it gave him a chance to kind of get himself kind of back into the groove of things and kind of introduce him to the new generation of hip hop listeners. And shout out to DOC on that, man. You still coming through. You still doing your thing. And you're not letting yourself get stopped. Now, the Eminem verse. It's almost like, man, anything this man touches, it just automatically gets demolished. It gets disintegrated. He was definitely coming through with some bars, man. The only downside to the overall song is that this kind of sounds like it was a rough draft, or it sounds like it was leaked and it wasn't completely done, because I can clearly hear the difference in music that these guys put out that's completely engineered, mixed and mastered and finished to the T versus hearing this. Now, again, I'm going to go out on a limb and I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt on it, because it doesn't necessarily sound like it was all the way completed from a quality standpoint. However, from the beat selection to how the vocals were laid to the audio levels on the vocals, everything sounded pretty on point. The beat selection itself, the beat was fire. And you know, I haven't heard one Dr. Dre beat that was trash to this day. I've been a fan of him for a very long time, and I have not heard a Dr. Dre beat that is trash. Same with Eminem. Have not heard an Eminem beat that was trash. So, going back to the overall quality of the song, to me, as a listener, and also someone who dibbles and dabbles on the post-production side of music, it sounds like there still needed to be some more work done on the engineering side. Everything else is fine. The way the verses was put down, everything else was fine. Now, what we are missing is an official music video. Now, if he had just sprung up out of nowhere with an official music video with the song and everything and had DLC in the video, man, I think it would have did even crazier numbers than it is now, because it's had almost 2.5 million views in under 4 days. So I definitely got to say this song was definitely out of left field, man. It's actually really, really good. And I like the chemistry that the three of these guys had on the track. I mean, you can't name me a Dr. Dre and Eminem song where the two of them on the track wasn't good. But to throw DLC in the mix and kind of get him back out there and kind of get him back in the groove of doing things, it was a pleasant surprise. And overall, I think the song is great. I think everything about it is good. The only downside is the loss of quality on the engineering side. But other than that, everything was good. And I got to give these guys their roses, man. So with that being said, that's pretty much my reaction, man. So if you like the video, go ahead and give it a like. Share it with a couple of your friends. Make sure you follow me on all my social media sites. And if you got something specific, go ahead and drop it in that comment section, man. It's your boy, Anonymous Bass. Peace.
Started two shots back for my dearly departed. You are now dealing with a monster. Oh, shit. Profits. Dr. Dre, bitch, I'm a prophet. Black Wall Street, niggas know where the stock is. Try me. Niggas never see me, but it ain't hard to find me. Unwinding, shit's blinding. Still grinding, uprising. Stop talking about the past, I'm the future, nigga. Nigga like me, still here, motherfucker, go figure. Looking for my next gold digger. This summer here gonna be colder than winter. Already told you, I fold you like hundreds of billions, and you can go missing, put that on my children. Bet that, nigga, what?